Hi, my name is Danny Amo. I'm going to present our work, 7 Principles to Foster Privacy and Security in Educational Tools, a Local Educational Data Analytics. In our work, we are saying that the people behind or those services behind learning analytics are misusing our data, and our data are transferred to the cloud computing. And when data is transferred to the cloud computing, we are absolutely losing data control. So we can give a head like this to all the students or other educational roles, or we can begin to think just a little bit different. So our proposal is to begin to think more locally, okay? We have to begin to use local computing instead of cloud computing. And this results in a local learning analytics. If we do this shift in our thinking, okay, take the local first approach instead of the cloud computing, okay, we are giving students data control, trust in the institution, and some more points that I'm going to present you. Okay, so let's begin with the framework. The first point is legality. Of course, every edtech have to comply with legality, okay, but legality is punitive, it's non-preventive, and in some ways, edtech have to automate those regulations, okay, to make legality preventive instead of punitive. The point number two is about transparency, information, and expiration. It's to say that students and educational role have to be informed and have to know how their data is going to be transformed and used, and who is going to use that information or collected data. Point number three is about data control. Data control is about trust. If students have their data controlled, institutions are gaining trust. So we have to try to give all the control to the students using local devices instead of cloud computing devices. We achieve this data control in a first step. Principle number four is about anonymous transaction, okay? This point is about encryption, because if you are anonymous, you can decide when your information is private or when your information is public. And this gives control to the students and each of every educational role in an educational community. Point number five is about responsibility in the code. We bet for open source, because if a tool is open sourced, we can evaluate, we can audit, we can certificate that this tool is doing what this tool says. Number six is about, it's about interoperability, okay? All the tools, okay, have to integrate seamlessly. When students have to be able to transfer data from one application to another application, encrypted, of course, and augment or in some way to create a kind of interoperability technological system or ecosystem of tools that helps students achieve their objective, their learning objectives. With encryption, we can achieve good levels of privacy. And then we have the 7 principles, and the most important principles is in this framework, because all the other points are orchestrated by this local first. And local first is idea about zero distance between devices. Okay, let's think about a NetTech application, use it in a classroom. Usually these kind of applications use the cloud computing. Our idea is that the data is not transferred to the cloud computing, but it's only transferred to the devices that are near these students. And of course, these 7 principles, local first, have to be seen in the center, and the other orbitating this 7 and most important point, it's obvious that doesn't solve or don't solve every problem of learning analytics. Let's debate it, let's talk about it. But we think that if we do the things just a little bit different, okay, like thinking locally instead of moving data to the cloud computing, we can achieve good levels or best levels of privacy, security, and confidentiality of data, personal data, and metadata of educational roles.